कैमरा हिल गया.
ओके ईयरफोन्स आर नॉट लुकिंग बैड राइट.
सॉरी सॉरी.
टेक टू गाइस.
चलो 5 6 7 स्टार्ट.
हेलो एवरीबॉडी, वेलकम टू सनसेली सिनेहोलिक. दिस इज मुग्धा एंड वेल वेल वेल, लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस यू ऑल टू अ न्यू सीरीज ऑन माई चैनल कॉल्ड विंटेज रील, वेयर देर विल बी अ लॉट्स ऑफ डिस्कशन, टॉक्स एंड बीच बीच में थोड़े से ट्रिवियाज रिलेटेड टू फ्यू ओल्ड मूवीज दैट आई लव एडमायर. एंड टुडे आई हैव क्वाइट अ लवली पर्सन विद मी, रितिका टंडन, माई फेलो कॉलेज मेट. सो हे रितिका, वाई डोंट यू इंट्रोड्यूस पीपल अबाउट योर सेल्फ अ लिटल बिट.
Hi guys, I'm Ritika Tandon. I'm an architecture student and I just love watching Bollywood movies. So when I was young, I started performing Kathak and that's when I had this love for classics. And so I'm here with Mukta reviewing Gurudutt's classic movies.
So today we will be discussing about few of our favorite movies of the legendary filmmaker, actor and producer Gurudutt. And I would like to begin this conversation with a disclaimer that we are no film critics, we are no sophisticated cinema students, we are just two cineholics, or like cinephile is the right word to use, who are here to discuss about the movies that we love and admire. So first trivia for you all guys, because it's very important, that the real name of Gurudutt is Vasant Kumar Shivshankar Padukone. Since a lot of you don't know this, so we should begin with the basic information. And Ritika, why don't we start with your favorite Gurudutt film?
So my favorite all-time favorite movie is Mr. and Mrs. 55. First of all, I love Madhubala and I love rom-com movies of Bollywood. So that's the main reason that I love Mr. and Mrs. 55, and it is a complete paisa vasool Bollywood movie that you can just watch, binge watch anytime, anywhere, and you will just feel very light and have fun.
So even like I like Mr. and Mrs. 55 a lot. So this is one thing that I admire about Gurudutt's work a lot, that if you see a larger picture, he has contributed in both kind of cinema, the commercial cinema and the meaningful cinema, or the cinema beyond entertainment as we call it. He made movies like Mr. and Mrs. 55, Arpar, Jal or CID, but at the same time he directed Pyasa, Kagaz Ke Phool and even Saheb Biwi aur Gulam for that matter, which he didn't direct exactly, but he produced it. But what I really want to say is that he chose to present all kind of stories, which is, I think, quite impressive.
So let me tell you all the story of Mr. and Mrs. 55. Dutt plays a very charming, unemployed cartoonist named Preetam. Further, he meets Anita, which is played by a very, very beautiful and versatile actress of Bollywood, Madhubala, and her aunt, Sita Devi, which is played by Lalita Pawar. Sita Devi is a man-hating feminist. She wanted to get Anita married for her own selfish good, to take all the inheritance that Anita's father had left. Sita Devi made a plan where she would hire Preetam to be the temporary husband for Anita. So, and then they'll get divorced after she gets the inheritance. But Preetam and Anita keep falling in and out of love.
Yeah, that too was pretty much about Mr. and Mrs. 55. And you know, agar koi Mr. and Mrs. 55 ki baat bhi karta hai, you know, even somebody takes the name of the film, the first image that comes in my head is of Johnny Walker with a phone singing, Jaane kaha mera jigar gaya ji, abhi abhi yahi tha ki dhar gaya ji. That is like it. Although it's a light, breezy kind of movie, but I think that it does get a little anti-feminist at point.
I completely agree with you. Like, there are two types of worlds that are shown in the movie. One where there's the divorce bill that has been passed and women are getting a lot more freedom and everything. But on the other hand side, there are a lot of judgmental comments that are placed on a woman, that she's complete only when she gets married and she has to take care of her husband and kids and be at home. So there are these two worlds that are created in the movie, which is kind of the low point of the movie. Yeah, that I completely agree with you.
Like totally. At various points, aisa laga ki traditionalism ko itna zyada glorify kar diya hai ki even the good parts about Sita Devi, about being a feminist or trying to work for like women's freedom and they don't need men or some stuff like that, it almost felt ki everything that she's talking about is bad because she became such a toxic character. But yeah, obviously it was the point of conflict in the film, and also I think film was kind of fighting against the corrupting influence of the westernization on Indians urban rich us time par, because उस टाइम पर वेस्टर्नाइजेशन का ज़्यादा इन्फ्लुएंस हो रहा था है वो, बट आई डोंट नो एग्जैक्टली वर्ड, आई मीन देर आर अ लॉट ऑफ पॉइंट्स दैट यू कैन इंटरप्रेट, बिकॉज इट वॉज मेड इन द 50s, यू डोंट नो वॉट एग्जैक्टली वॉज हैपनिंग एट दैट पॉइंट, देर आर वेरियस थिंग्स दैट यू हैव टू टेक इन टू कंसिडरेशन, बट या इट फेल्ट अ लिटल प्रॉब्लमैटिक इन बिट्स एंड पार्ट्स, इट वॉज डेफिनेटली प्रॉब्लमैटिक इन बिट्स एंड पार्ट्स.
आई कम्प्लीटली अग्री विद यू मुग्धा. फॉर मी ऑल्सो फेमिनिज्म इज अबाउट हाउ there is equality between a man and a woman, and it's not about hating a man or hating a woman, it's about how they team up and bring about a change.
Yeah, that's actually correct, that's very true, and you know, it's fine, it's a good movie, it's not like we are hating on that film or anything, but it's good to like always observe and take out the problematic aspects that you felt that were present over there. So yeah, that's it. We love Mr. and Mrs. 55, guys. There is no boycott thingy happening. Please, nothing. We love cinema. We admire cinema.
The movie is a black and white movie, but still they have put together the sets which look so appealing and aesthetic, and they show a very beautiful part of
Mumbai. That's quite true. Like, I love the... I think that's the one thing that... like, why I love old movies. Because it's like a time machine. You are just like teleported to a whole new era. And you're just through the world of cinema, and through that film, you're just experiencing everything, a story, a world, like how telephones used to be, or how people used to dress up, or how they used to have a conversation, everything. I think that's one of the biggest things why I love old movies. Obviously, the visual aesthetics, the V.K. Murthy cinematography captured amazing things in the film. But one thing that I really love about Gurudutt movies are the dialogues. Specifically in Mr. and Mrs. 55, there are some amazing, witty, funny dialogues. Specifically that one where there's like, Tum communist ho, and Gurudutt is like, Nahi, main cartoonist ho. It's so funny and witty. Like, there are tons of amazing punches and amazing funny lines. You just laugh out loud with all those things. And you know, there was one thing ki maine jab Sahib Bibi aur Gulam pehli baar dekhi thi, and I really thought for a long amount, like long time, that it's directed by Gurudutt, because I think Gurudutt was in the film, and the whole film was so much like a Gurudutt movie, you know, a self-destructive character. The close-up shots, the use of light and everything, it really gave me the Gurudutt movie's vibe. But later on, I realized that it's Arbaar Alvi film. But yeah, that's possible because they had a good creative association for a long amount of time, that it's a possibility that they both got inspired with each other. But yeah, no doubt, Arbaar Alvi is a fascinating writer.
I completely agree with you. That is one of the reasons that the movie never gets boring. It has a very engaging storyline, and because of the characters, because of the screenplay, it never gets boring. You will be entertained the whole time.
Like, not just the writing part of the storyline is engaging, even the use of light is something so like fascinating about Gurudutt movies in general. The use of soft or subtle light in the most of his crucial scenes that brings all the intensity, you know. Even he played quite a lot in this movie as well, in Mr. and Mrs. 55. Like, you know, one scene where he meets Anita's mother, Sita Devi, to give her the picture of him with two other girls and alcohol and all. And the entry scene is quite impressive, you know. She's sitting and there's this light and a big shadow of Gurudutt approaching. And it's just so dramatic, and it gives like, oh my God, such amazing. You can interpret so many things in just that one scene. It's so fascinating about Gurudutt, how he played with shadows and light so flawlessly, I would say, I think.
Actually, both of the actors, Madhubala and Gurudutt, both of them have a very expressive acting. They might not say something, but the way they express it, just by their eyes and their smile or just looking down, that actually says everything that the scene demands.
Yeah, exactly. You know, even the like... that happens a lot in Gurudutt movies, I think, because he tends to take a lot of close-ups, specifically in subtle lights, like soft light. And, you know, I remember that scene in Mr. and Mrs. 55, jahan par, you know, Madhubala had that realization and she's figuring out if she like likes him a lot. And then there's this light and very dramatic scene, she's playing with her hairs and everything. That scene with a close-up. So it's quite fascinating how Gurudutt use shadows and every shadows and lights and close-ups. You know, it's amazing. It's effortless.
And the way she hangs on the door and waits for him, and there's then eye contact, there's music playing, then there's sudden realization of whether she wants to settle or she doesn't want to settle down. So there's a lot of thinking that is very well represented.
Yeah, exactly. That's true. I think that makes Mr. and Mrs. 55 quite engaging film for sure. And even like the songs are amazing.
The songs are very, very to the point. They have a conversation in between. So that if you have seen the movie and you listen to the songs after that, you know where was this song, what was the intent of the song. So there is a meaning into the songs. To be honest, now aajkal ke gaane I do not enjoy so much because I have heard Gurudat, Kishore Kumar, Mohammad Rafi, and I love those classics, which makes sense. And that is something maybe my family has incorporated in me because they love it so much. So now even I love it so much and they make much more sense.
That's true. That was pretty much about Mr. and Mrs. 55. Do you have anything else to say, Ritika, about it?
I just love it. Everybody must watch it at least once in their life. And Mr. and Mrs. 55 is a must watch. Watch it for Madhubala. If you love Nakhre and everything, you'll love this movie.
Thanks a lot for watching, guys. There is a part 2 coming soon on this channel where we will be talking about another Gurudat's classic. So subscribe to stay tuned. If you enjoyed this conversation, then do like and share. And in the comment section, do mention your favorite Gurudat film. Tab tak ke liye, bye.